Now, ladies and gentlemen, our next guest is a very funny man. He's making his network television debut with us tonight, so I couldn't be happier you're in such a good mood. He can be seen performing regularly at the Comedy Cellar right here in New York City. Ladies and gentlemen, a nice welcome for...
This is awesome. Thank you. Hi, everybody. You're all looking at me like, can this guy fix my printer? I know what I look like. Relax. It's the glasses. Skinny man glasses, you're screwed, computer programmer. That's what it is. Skinny man, no glasses. Accountant. By the way, I hate when people want to try my glasses. It drives me nuts. They're always like, I love your glasses. Can I try your glasses? Can I try your glasses? Then I let them try my glasses. They go parading around the room. What's the first thing they ask? How do I look? I don't know, blurry? I was gonna get the laser surgery. My friend and I were gonna do it, but he chickened out. I'm like, why'd you chicken out? He goes, dude, I was gonna do it, but the doctor says you can't drink for 2 days. I'm thinking, you got bigger problems than laser surgery. I was gonna do it, but it's like $5,000. I don't have $5,000. I don't have five. But my friend goes, don't worry about it, dude. I got a guy. What? He goes, I got a guy, 100 and I. A 100 and I for laser surgery? For 100 and I don't think the guy has a laser. He just has a magnifying glass and the sun. Don't turn your head. Don't turn your head. Don't turn your head, Lenny. It's almost 12 o'clock. Don't turn your head. Ooh, ants. What's the word dude? I should have known after he said dude, I got a guy. Just run. Look, I'm no genius, but nothing intelligent has ever been said after the word dude. You're never gonna hear, dude, scalpel. Yeah, I listened to that one time, and he was like, dude, I have an apartment for you. And now I live in New York City, in the hottest apartment ever in New York City. My apartment is 450 degrees at all times. It's so hot in my apartment, I don't have roaches. It's too hot for roaches. I have scorpions. One time my girlfriend comes in, she starts screaming at me, it's so hot in here, I can't take it anymore. Open the window, I'm sweating, we're breaking up, it's too hot. And I realize, I don't have a girlfriend, I'm hallucinating. Yeah, I don't have a girlfriend. I was dating this girl, but she was playing hard to get rid of. So we broke up, and people were like, was it a bad breakup? Was it a bad breakup? When's it a good breakup? When have you had a good breakup in your life? When have you had a breakup like, get your stuff and get the hell out in your new car? We couldn't even sleep in bed together. She would roll on top of me and hug me at all times to fall asleep. And I can't sleep like that. Can you people sleep like that? No, you can't say it. It's like hugging a radiator. You could die. I would wake up at 4 o'clock in the morning, sweat pouring off me. Nightmares, I was a quarterback being sacked all over the field. God forbid she woke up in the middle of the night and I had rolled over to the other side of the bed, she'd start crying, "What are you doing over there? What are you doing over there?" I'm breathing. Look, I get the romance of it, but the rule is business is in the middle. You gotta go to sleep, away. Away. Good night, everybody.
Good job, sir. Good luck to you. We'll be right back with Elizabeth Cook, everybody.